fans of Port Detroit. Gentlemen, it is Tuesday Night Sports Minutes on the TMA Radio Show. I'm your host, Minister Akritan. We are going to kick back with all the sports, NBA, and a recap of the NCAA Championship. You know, you can tell in my voice, I'm kind of speechless, but I just don't know what to say about the game. You know, I hear a lot of people that's not even Carolina fans talk about the game, but we'll get into that. So just stay tuned because it is Sports Night on the best gospel, the best praise talk show in America, the TMA Radio Show. Guys, those that just tuning in, thank you for listening to another segment of the TMA Radio Show, Tuesday Night Sports Minutes. And I tell you, man, we thank you for listening in. All right, we're ready to go into Sports Minutes. All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, listening sport fans in the world, hey man, let me tell you something. I'm still in shock about the game. I'm still in mourning about the game, and actually I'm upset. And I don't care what anybody say, I got my own opinion about the game. Now, I'm not going to take away from neither team. You hear me? Because Villanova played their hearts out. And I'm going to tell you people that criticize and got stuff to say, Carolina Blue came to play. So let's get that out the way. Both teams played their hearts out. Now, let's get it straight for those that did watch the game. Man, it was a one-sided call. Entire game, especially the first half, Carolina in foul trouble. I mean, we get called for little tacky fouls and then go down on offense and get smashed. Hand check to death, swiping at the ball, hitting fingers and body, page layups, buried layups, body, meets, grabs, jump ball, They called foul. Then they did the same play. They grabbed the ball from one ounce. Jump ball. They get the ball. Their possession. It was the most horrible. Horrible. I mean absolute horrible calls by the referee, and it doesn't make sense. I'm trying to tell you right now because it just blew my mind to watch the entire game as the whistle continued to blow on every player for Carolina. Now they had one or two maybe gotten in foul trouble, but we had four, five folks in foul trouble. It don't make any sense. And the NCAA always want to investigate colleges for doing something wrong. They are not never, I said never, ever, ever, never, ever let them refs, that referee the NCAA championship ever again. I'll put them in a recreational league and let them referee kids, because that was ridiculous. It makes me ill to even think about it. I got the whole game in my mind. I don't even have to watch it over again. You know, you have a loose ball on the floor. Offense, two people run, dive on the floor, and you call foul. What happened to the championship game? You letting the kids play? This is crazy. I mean, you know, yes, we missed some shots, and yes, we had some turnovers. But they was bumping us to death. I mean, Bryce Johnson had the ball. They bumped him. They didn't see it. He lost the ball. Their ball. How in the world? Just a little nudge, and they didn't, you know. But, you know, like I said, they won, but we played six men on the court the entire time. We had to play not only the team, but we had to play against the refs as well. I mean, I had to get on Twitter and send NCAA some messages today, along with ESPN and First Take. And maybe they didn't even read it. But I'm so sick, because they should have made it evenly. And I don't know who watched the game. I was talking to a friend of mine earlier today, and he said the game was pretty much officiated on both sides. And I said, no, man, I don't know if you can go back and Google that, man, because every time we turn around in the first half, by them getting us all those calls, I'm gonna tell you right now, it threw us out our game, and we got upset, and then, you know, we fighting the refs, we trying to play a good game, they strap it, we trying to match the strap it, but we getting called for fouls, you know. But how in the world did we let this joker go down and shoot a three-point without even guarding the three-point line? Oh, man, I thought it was going to overtime, man. I was like, yes, boy, just let these 4 seconds run off the clock. We can go to overtime recap. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. And this joker had to hit the shot. I mean, he had to hit the shot. Chris Jenkins. Stankin' Jenkins. Man. Oh, boy. That was a rough one, man. And we played behind the entire second half with about 10, 12 minutes in the second half. And then for Paige to come down and knock a shot down for us to tie it up, man, and possibly go into overtime. Oh, man, that was breathtaking, man. I was just blown away. But you know what? If I had the power, them referees would never referee an NCAA game again. I'm not talking about Villanova team. I'm not talking about them. They played their hearts out, as we did too. And it's not their fault that the referees didn't blow their whistles to death on us and didn't make it an even fight, man. You know, I'd have got a tech if I was Roy. You know, bad enough we getting beat up. But they all over the place, jumping on our back like we a merry-go-round, and they lolly-dolly, lolly-dolly, and no foul call. Just makes me just angry, man, I tell you. And I'm just a competitor. I'm really a competitor. And some of us got the competitiveness, and some of us don't. But I'm a winner. And I know we can't win all the time, but man, I almost can taste that trophy. The national trophy. Golly. Ooh-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-wee. Man. 3-point shot beater, buzzer beater. Man. I'm just like, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, why did we block? Why didn't we secure the 3-point line? Oh boy. Oh man, I don't know. I just, you know, I know that we needed to press to try to, you know, but maybe we had a zone or maybe we was able to protect the 3-point line. I don't know. Maybe, you know, I just don't know. But I just, that's a heartbreaker, man. It's gonna take me a couple days to get over this. You know, I'm still smiling. I'm still going on my day. But I'm still not happy. And NCAA, I know you'll never listen to my radio show. But if you happen to, you want to investigate something? Maybe, matter of fact, maybe you need to be investigated, because maybe it was some shady stuff going on while the ref continued to call 170 calls to 5. You call 175 million calls on us and 5 calls on Villanova. Such a shame. Because that do take the game out of man. I mean, it takes a lot of our player. A player can't even play, you know, straight up basketball. They scrapping us to death. They all on us. They bodying us. But we do it, we get fouled. And so that ought to have some bearing. Somebody ought to look at that. As a matter of fact, maybe the NCAA need to be investigated, because maybe they had something to do with it. I'm just speculating, and I'm telling you, I'm fired up. I need some water. Hey, bring on the water. Man, I just don't know what to say. Golly, a buzzer beater at the end of the game with no time on the clock. He hit 3. So that's all they gonna say. They ain't gonna say nothing about the poor officiating the entire game that was one-sided. They ain't gonna talk about that, but they gonna play that last minute shot to death. I mean, they gonna run it until the wires burn inside the computer. They gonna play that over and over on ESPN to death. I mean, they play that shot, they rewind it and play it over and over and over and over and over and over again. And look at that. And then them commentators, man, they were rooting for Villanova. The one guy, he was like, come on cats. And I'm sitting like, man, you a commentator for both teams, or you just rooting and hoping Carolina lose? Get him off the air. Can I take his spot? And I'll probably do the same thing, but I don't know if he went to Villanova or not. But hey man, I tell you, they need me on there, you know, commentating one of them games that Carolina play in. I'm gonna make it fun to death. But 77-74. Man, and oh, and you got to do this all over again next year to even try to be in the dance. Whew, man. It's been a long time since we had a national championship. And this would have just made the icing on the cake, with the cake tasting better, winning the national championship. Man, we ain't won it in a long time, man. 2008, man, it just... Then Duke won it. And like Duke and Carolina go back and forth with titles. But I guess, you know, we got the ACC regular season champions. You know, that's better than a zero. but I hate to lose with such a poor officiating game. And I know I'm dragging this out because I'm hot. I'm hot like fire. You can put water on my hair, it'll boil 109 degrees Fahrenheit. I mean, I'm like a baked oven right now. I can blow on a piece of chicken and it turns golden brown. I'm so hot, man. It just don't make any sense. I can eat fire and fire go out. Woo-wee, that's hot at it, baby. That's hot at it. Man, I'm tired of tape, man. I take some charcoal, chew the charcoal, but the charcoal just disintegrate. That's how hot I am. I'm hot like lava. I'm just, man, you take my temperature, man, that thing a bust. I know it don't sound like it, but I tell you right now, if they let me be in the press conference, and I got something to say to the NCAA, because they want to investigate somebody, they need to investigate them referees. And every time we had the whistleblower, even when we got a ball called that, you know, the ball went our way, ball went out of bounds, or something happened, when that whistleblower, boy, everybody tensed up because we were like, damn, they're going to call everybody. I mean, I went to my parents' house for a little bit of the second half, and everybody was like, oh, Lord, they're going to another foul. And they were like, oh, no, it ain't. We got the ball. You see, you shouldn't have be watching a game and you feel like that. Y'all understand? That's what I'm talking about. The whole room shouldn't be like, damn, you know, God, we got another foul. They be like, oh, no, 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 it's our ball. Woo. You know, you blowing. You're like getting a weight room and waiting for the baby to be born. And, woo. All right, that's enough of that. I'm done. Hey, if anybody got the NCAA phone number, give it to me. You can call me up, 919-521-4741. Hey, let's go into the NBA. All right, the NBA score right now, Pelicans and the 76ers, 106-88 in the fourth quarter, 3 minutes to go. Hornets and the Raptors, Raptors are beating the Hornets, 64-49, third quarter, 5 minutes, 26 seconds left. Pistons and the Heat, they're in the second quarter, 1 minute to go. Heat leading that one by 52-32. And we have Suns and the Hawks. Suns halftime, 56-44. Bulls at the half. With the Grizzlies leading that one 54-44. And we got another whole half Thunder. Let me go back. The Cavs. There's Cavs and the Bucks. Halftime Cavaliers winning that one 67-43. Thunder and the Nuggets come on at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Spurs and the Jazz also at 9. And we have at 10 o'clock, Trailblazers and the Kings. 10:30, Timberwolves and the Warriors. 10:30, Lakers and the Clippers. And let me tell you something. Syracuse and Connecticut. The end of the first. Connecticut 28-13 right now. Y'all hear me? Do y'all hear me? It's gonna take me a few days, you know. I'm gonna go on with my day. I'm gonna speak to people and still work, take care of my family. Matter of fact, came home today, cooked on the grill, man. Some great bird, man. I'm trying to tell you, I'm not trying to toot my own horn. You know, people have designated me to cook for the Relay of Life because they know that I can throw down on the chicken. On anything, really, but man, I put some on them birds, and I think if they get the same type that they got last time, those quarters, man, I'm telling you, when I put some rub on that baby, and man, and got the charcoal just right, and smoking it, I don't have to look at it all the time because I know exactly how much charcoal and I know what to do. And I don't have to turn it over and keep opening and letting the heat out. I can't stand going to a barbecue and somebody every time they're going to check on it every 3-4 minutes. No, if you get your fire right, you ain't got to keep checking on your meat. And you ain't got to put a whole bag of charcoal in it. Have you ever been somewhere, a cookout or a church function, and we got all these cooks, and jokers put a whole 5-pound bag in a small grill and go light it on fire, put a half a put a half a thing of lighter fluid in there, and the whole thing red at the bottom. That, I mean, the grill on fire. They can make a sword that's so hot. they're a blacksmith. They gonna put some shoes on a horse. But I'm gonna tell you, if you get your fire right, you get that heat right, and you know, spread it out like you need to, you ain't gotta keep checking on it. And if you let the coals get a certain temperature before you put the meat on it, you ain't gonna have no problem with blazing up fire. You been to those barbecue, people got to throw water on their fire because the fire done blazed up, burnt the meat. The meat still ain't done. It's raw. I don't want them kind of cooks. No. Have you ever had somebody cook a hamburger? It look bright. It look golden brown on the outside, but you crack it open, raw to death. I mean, blood raw. Them the cooks you need to stay away from the grill. They gonna get somebody sick. But hey, I thank God for many talents. God has blessed me with many talents. And I'm not bragging, but I just praise God for many talents. Be able to cook, be able to sing a little bit, be able to draw, be able to use my hands with different crafts and skills that I got. God has blessed me tremendously with different talents and wisdom, and I thank Him for it. All right, my fans, my sports listeners tonight, meet us here next Tuesday. We started a little bit after 8 o'clock, but always between 7 and 8 p.m. We'll be starting up on the Tim A Radio Show. So tune in next week for more sports to come. NBA is heating up, getting down to the playoff time. It's getting ready to get serious. Until next time, I want you to be blessed. Continue to listen. We got weather coming up, so stay tuned.
Take you way back.
Way back, way back,
way back.
Yo, yo.
As it goes a little something like this.
Yo,
finish the K to the J. J to the 5. 5 to the 2. It's time to get live. Party people in the house should be feeling alright. Throw your hands in the air, wave your sides aside. Dip, dip, dive, you can socialize. You can lime to the lemon, you can lemon to the lime. But 9 years ago, a friend of mine hit me up and just to ask the time. I'm looking out my watch, he said 11:45.
Okay.
He shook his head, he had something to tell. He said, check out my brother, now it's plain to see. I'm gonna make it plain, just as plain can be. Cause you here, and you there.
Where you at?
But a life without Christ ain't going nowhere. And I was just like you, I was jamming on it. Then he sang a little song, a little something like this. Hit it, we rock the mic, rock the mic. Just two turntables in the crack. When you change right, he was in the house, so you feeling okay.
Word.
And let the record play all night.
All night, all
we
day.
We rock the mic in a different way. Just two turntables in the crack. When you change right, he was in the house, so you feeling okay. And let the record play all night.
All night, all day.
Stop a second. Stop. I need to hear more. He said I came through the door and I said it before.
Word.
But you didn't listen to me this first time. So open your mind and let me open your eyes. Cause the blind lead the blind. Can't you see that, my brother?
Nah.
It's like a jungle. Sometimes it makes me wonder if you're going under and you blind to the fact it ain't where you're from and it ain't where you're at. It ain't the radio cause Al's a Kango hat. Now you be yelling and it's like that. Now your life's whack, just broken pieces. You got Adidas but you ain't got Jesus. In a hotel, a motel, over Holiday Inn. Nah, now it don't mean nothing cause you like Keith's fighting and you still lost in sin. I said a hotel, a motel, over Holiday Inn. Now it don't mean nothing cause you like Keith's fronting and you still lost in sin. Let me say it like, we rock the mic in a different way. Croak, and one thing I'll tell you, gonna rock the bells all the way to hell, and all the ballers, shot callers, making paper, all the players, you gonna catch vapors, lottie dottie, who likes to party, you think you the man, but you really ain't nobody, it was the lamb who was led to the slaughter, rose and made the planet rock like Bambada, the one who knows the clay just like the potter, the one who sits the spirit, son and the father, the one who divides land, sea and the water, God's son, we welcome back like Carter,
we rock the mic in a different way, just two turns.
Him up, hiya,
and not of ourselves,
somebody
y'all.
Somebody lifts him, hiya.
It is a gift of God,
come on,
not of
lift
works.
Him up, hiya.
Lift any man should boast.
What shall I render unto you, Lord, for all the things that you have done for me? All that I have is you who has given. Silver and gold, they all belong to you.
You give more grace to lay your gold as dust. When the labor is much, when trials come, place my feet on the rock. I will be still, cause I know you are God. Exceeding everywhere, exceeding here and there, exceeding every day. I see signs and wonders, exceeding everywhere, exceeding here and there, exceeding every day. That is my portion.
Grace, I need you more. What can say? Love is everything you can have to say. So why do you wanna give upon yourself? My grace is enough for you, the Bible says. Was bound in prison, locked up in chains, and held me trapped to sorrow and pain. Years of frustration and shame, but it came and washed me now, no more stains. It is by grace that we are saved. Act of kindness, a type we don't deserve. God's riches at Christ's expense. Anybody here who knows this type of grace? He is my salvation and strength. Have his DNA in my veins. Since the day he washed me clean, life has never been the same.
Everywhere, exceeding here and there, exceeding every day. I see signs and wonders, exceeding everywhere, exceeding here and there, exceeding every day. That is my portion.
Gee, what shall I render for all the things you've done to answer? What kind of love so tender? Has no limit, has no measure. What shall I give for love? Everything I have is yours. The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. The cows and the thousand hills is yours. Jehovah Jireh, my provider, Savior, healer, awesome wonder. You are the unchanging changer. Even when I'm wrong, still loves me tender. Grace took Joseph to the palace. Esther was crowned by Ahasuerus. Amazing grace, thou sweet the sound. I once was lost, but now I'm found. What kind of God is this? The heavens and the earth adore you. All the angels bow before you. Your grace is enough for me. I love you.
Grace to lay up gold as dust. You add favor when the labor is much. When trials come, place my feet on the rock. I will be still, cause I know you are God.
Exceeding everywhere,
exceeding here and there, exceeding every day. I see signs and wonders, exceeding everywhere.
wonders exceeding grace,
everywhere,
exceeding grace,
there and there,
exceeding grace,
every day.
That is my portion.
Cheer. Chopsticks on the beat. Fearless.
Dollars Infinity.
Say, 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 oh, I know.
Hey. My life and he turned me around, oh, turned me around, yeah, hey. Now I get to eat and I get to drink, all my enemies must fall for beat. I don't need to worry, cause I know I get plenty money. See, see, I've already fall a ballet, now to the heat to go for money. Got now the king, must stop ballet. That's why I go there, live too much money, money, but the best, okay. Everybody make me the bullet.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got one more song, brothers and sisters, for you tonight on the TMA Radio Show Sports Minute. Meet us here tomorrow night for midweek praise, and bring your praise shoes, because we're going to give God praise for keeping us safe, for watching over us, providing for us, and being who He is, a loving God that never fails. Tomorrow between 9 and 10 p.m. for midweek praise, and want you to have a blessed night tonight and pray for somebody that's in your neighborhood. Pray for somebody that you may not know that's going through. You know they're going through, but you do not know them. Send a word of prayer up for them and let them know that somebody's thinking about them. Let them know that somebody is standing in the gap for them. That's what we can do. That's what we can do. I love you with the love of the Lord. I want you to be blessed and have a great day tomorrow.
Say they like me,
yeah.
I had some say they wanna be me. Nah,
That's so funny, it's not about me. If your daddy must tag, then it's all about him.
Okay.
They like fun, yeah. They wanna have some. They wanna run around, it's Jerry like Tom. No son, you know the clock's ticking. We only got time to go about teaching. Dilly, jelly, we penetrate many. It's change on our minds, so it's not about the money. Shelly, you would see it on my outfit. Living is Christ and to die, profit. Hang so high, praise most high. In heaven's strength, making me so fly. I want boys, them wanna be us, cause I'm a chug boy. Chug boy job, grace goes up, grace comes down. We're living as kings, so we own this ground. If grace not fair, then my skin goes brown. I'm a chug boy. Chug boy job. Frankly speaking, I'm doing my thing. Regardless of what people might be thinking, they say I'm a Jew man based on looking, but I say that work is so misleading. Drop that thinking, drop that doubting, drop that feeling of unbelieving. Walk by faith, don't go by looking. Gaze on the Most High and stop that blinking. Lately I have been feeling so high, smoking the word, now I'm looking so fly. It's not about me, it's about the Most High. Resurrection was all about me. My head goes swollen. Eyes go pumping. Let's get set, cause I'm feeling like dancing. Talking in tongues, now I'm feeling like stepping. The script on my mind, Jude 1:20. Hang up high, praise most high. In heaven's strength, making me so fly. I want boys, them wanna be us, cause I'm a chug boy. Chug boy job. Grace goes up, grace comes down. We're living as kings, so we own this ground. It's not fair, then my skin goes brown. I'm a chug boy, chug boy Joe.
I'm a shush boy, shush boy. I'm a shush boy, you see, I'm a shush boy. I'm a shush boy, I'm a shush boy. I'm a shush boy, you see, I'm a shush boy.
So weird and act so loud. Maybe because I'm so endowed, so I scream out loud. Yo, hey, that's a lie. Folks these days just make me scream. They also Thomas believe in the scene. They go about doing what they see on screen, but we all gon' make them join this team. About that Mac 1615, we all just act like it's not being seen. Creating a beef with a script like this, go make that like go. We can deem. Time to speak it, time to teach it. Shine that light, let the whole world see it. Make that heat so your folks can feel it. Stand up tall, you are not that midget. Hands up high, praise most high. In heaven's strength, making me so fly. I want boys, them wanna be us, cause I'm a chug boy. Chug boy job, grace goes up, grace comes down. We're living as kings, so we own this ground. If grace not fair, then my skin goes brown. Chug boy, Chug boy Joe.